We either have to play the same ones over again or play our lesser songs. I hope you guys can deal with the lesser songs.
Oh, stop.
Okay.
What? Do you want to do the second set?
Yeah.
All right.
So the name of this little outfit here is called the Mercenes. And I, a number of people, to me it's obvious, you see the name and people, it should be pronounced Mercenes, but a lot of people look at that name and they ask themselves, I wonder how you pronounce it. And if you type it into Google, it will autocorrect to Mercedes. And you might have to type it 3 or 4 times to get it to be the Mercenes, but it'll still never tell you how to pronounce it. So it's called the Mercenes. And Bonnie, what in the world is a Mercene?
From what I understand, a Mercene is a wanderer from the land of mercy.
I hope to someday wander into the land of mercy. And if I get there, I'm there definitely not wandering from it.
Well, all you have to do is mend your ways.
And we played our mission statement already. A lot of the songs we're going to play for you are songs that I wrote. And but I do have a mission statement, you know, for what we do. And it's taken from a song that I really liked growing up. The song's called I'll Be Your Mirror. And, you know, like all good nonprofit mission statements, it has 3 prongs. I'll be your mirror, reflect what you are, in case you don't know. Now, when I look in the mirror, I sometimes don't like what I see. I do my best to spruce up a little bit. You know, if I have crumbs on my face, I wonder why nobody told me about it. If I have ink on my forehead, I'm glad I looked in the mirror. So hopefully you'll see some of yourself in these songs. And we describe what we do as musical portraits and cinematography of the soul. So hopefully if you close your eyes, you'll see the movie that we're imagining. Bonnie, what's this first song we're going to play?
We're going to be playing I'll Be Your Mirror.
Are we really?
Weren't you just talking about that?
I thought I'll Be Your Mirror was in the other set.
That's the first set. No, I'll Be Your Mirror is the first song.
Oh, well, how about that?
So well, you can do the first song and first set.
I thought we were doing the second set.
Well, do it. You just told people about I'll Be Your Mirror. I think we should do it.
Your door to show that you're home when you think the night has seen your mind, that inside you're twisted and unkind. Let me stand to show that you are blind. Please put down your hands, 'cause I see you. When you think the night has seen your mind, that inside you're twisted and unkind. Let me stand to show that you are blind. Please put down your hands, 'cause I see you. Know the beauty you are.
I guess what they call at-risk youth. And I used to bring some of the at-risk youth up here and check books out for them on my library card. And they would invariably lose them. So Red Hill Library forgave me about $40 worth of overdue fines and three or four lost books. So thank you. And I don't think those kids ever really read a book anyhow. They just wanted, you know, to humor me, because I think what they really wanted was to get on those computers and get on Facebook. Bonnie, what do we have?
Well, I think we should continue with this first set because we didn't complete it at the last gig, and there are some good songs in there. So let's just do it. Okay? It's Dark Times.
All right.
This is a song that Robert did write.
Yeah, this is one of those literary songs. Do you want to know the truth, or do you want me to make up the story? I have a made-up story, and I have a real story. Which do you prefer? In this age of fake news, you probably would prefer the fake story.
No.
No?
These folks would prefer the real story.
The real story? Nonfiction? Yes. You guys are nonfiction readers? Okay.
You can't think it out, can you?
Oh, no. Actually, there's elements of truth in both. I've just told so many lies in my life, I get them confused. But there was a friend of mine in a band I played with back in Pittsburgh. The drummer and I shared a house. And one night I came home, and he had a friend visiting. And she was on her way to join a convent up in the tundra of Canada. But she wanted to stop and say hello to all of her good friends before she ran off. And she had a dream. And it turns out that her best friend had the exact same dream on the exact same night. So against advice, they went to a psychic. And the psychic was going to interpret the dream for them. And of course, the psychic was a little bit of a predator, and he tried to convince them to allow themselves to be hypnotized. And then while they were hypnotized, he was going to regress them into their past lives, which, of course, to me is just a bunch of hocus pocus. But next day, I'm driving through Castle Shannon, Pennsylvania, and I look through the window of a Burger King, and there's this woman sitting there. So I pull in and ask her, you know, hey, how'd your session with the psychic go? And she was all glassy-eyed, and she said, oh, it was really amazing. He tried to regress me into my past life, and something went wrong, and I ended up in the future. I says, oh, really? Well, what's it like in the future? So I really can't describe it, except for this really, really nice, and they look back on us like we're living in the Dark Ages. So this is a song called Dark Times. Although in the future they'll say these were dark times. Though in the future they'll say we were violent. Although in the future they'll say these were dark times. The leaders were deaf and their poets were silent. Although in the future they'll say these were dark times. Simply close their eyes. Although in the future they'll say these were dark times. The poets were silent unless they told lies. I'm talking to you, always flirting with danger. I'm talking to you, titillated by fear. You always flirting with danger. You won't flirt with me, you're afraid to come here. I'm looking at you, a new wave of voyeurs. A massive black coma head, lazy eye.
talking to you with my words fall on deaf ears. Maybe it's my words that are deafening. I'm talking to you because I have to do something. And this, for the moment, is all I can do.
They'll be torn between pity and flat disbelief.
They wonder how we could allow this to happen.
How could this happen?
The poets were silent and the truth was asleep.
Thank you.
You guys hear about all that trouble that they had down in Charlottesville, Virginia? I was in Charlottesville, Virginia, and I wandered into a used bookstore, because that's what I do when I travel. And I was looking for an old music book, and I found this old hymnal, a Christian Science hymnal from like 1895, 1896. And I went through and picked out all the coolest lines and stuck them in one song, and set it to the melody of Hymn 100, which is known as Old Hundredth. And so we're going to do Hymn 100 with composite lyrics done Buddy Holly style.
joy of life, there fears no death.
A lot of the songs that I wrote, you know, can't really claim that I wrote them because I eavesdropped on other people's conversations and just took what they said and stuck it into a song. This next song is called Mother of Three, which is word for word out of the mouth of my sister, who was lamenting that she couldn't be free like me, run around wherever I want to run around, play my guitar whenever I want to play my guitar. You know, she's got to be there taking care of those kids. And I look at her with envy.
But everybody told us it's a natural phase. I was already carrying our first child. I could see what was headed our way. Our friends, our preachers, our parents too. Now I'm not gonna say they didn't care. They said, that's life. You'll learn. You'll see. I think I've seen more than my share. I never was a wide-eyed girl as a kid. I thought every possibility through. But there was so much I couldn't anticipate, and once it happens, it's hard to undo. They tell me I'm young, I should grow up and get real. Wise, the world doesn't revolve around me. Why is everybody so easily pleased? Or maybe the problem is me. Mother of three, what have I done? I look at myself and wonder what I've become. Nothing in life is what I hoped it would be. Just look at me now, I'm a mother of three. Husband of mine is not a bad man. He does his best. I mean, it's not his fault. It's not like I've seen anyone better, and any other woman worth half her salt would know how lucky I am to have all this. I've never been deprived. Is it too much to ask to want to know how it feels to be loved? To feel alive. I'm a mother of three. What have I done? I look at myself and wonder what I've become. Nothing in life is what I hoped it would be. Look at me now. I'm a mother of three. Is just learning to crawl, and the one in the middle never cries or complains, cause she's the most like me of them all. But when's it ever gonna be my turn?
never, 'cause my turn was not meant to be. I don't need another reminder that the world does not revolve around me. I don't need another reminder that the world does not revolve around me. I'm a mother of three, what have I done? I look at myself and wonder what I've become. Nothing in life is what I hoped it would be. Look at me now, I'm a mother of three. Nothing in life is what I hoped it would be. Look at me now, I'm a mother of three. Nothing in life is what I hoped it would be. Look at me now, I'm a mother of three. Thank you. Actually, I'm a mother of four.
1927, which is the year my grandmother was born in 1910 in what's now the Slovak Republic. And, school wasn't all that important to kids back then because they basically lived on the farm, took care of some animals, you know. And from what I understand, the women did all the work. The men just sat around, smoked cigars, and drank beer, and the women tended the farm. My grandmother didn't think that was very good, and she wanted a better way of life. So she went to school, and when she came to the United States in 1927, she believed she was coming here to go to college. And then she was met at the train station by my grandfather, who said, "Your dad sent you here to marry me." Of course, this, I'm telling you the story that's in
the
song. Yes,
let's sing the story.
So, the story's in the song. Either way, the smartest person I ever knew never learned to read English. A story begins as an historical fact. A soot-covered platform by the railroad track. My grandfather waited for his bride to come. He'd never seen her face before. He made a simple deal with a man back home who'd send his eldest daughter to the wild unknown to marry that enterprising man of dreams. They didn't bother telling her. He could see her dread. He told her, "You can go your own way instead. But you got no money and no friends here. You better come along with me." When they took their vows, what could she say? She could promise to honor him and obey. But under the circumstances, God must know, she could never love a man that way. The more she knew him, the less she liked. She did her duty as his lawful wife. Gave birth three times and had the son to carry forth his name. She reasoned, prayed, hoped for the best. God must have a reason, but it's not for me to know. Seventy years since the day they met, the rags not turned to riches yet. One by one they're laid to rest. The dream he sends to me, knocked down, rise, knocked down again. It's a way of life for working men. I won't wait till it does begin. The dream descends for me. While the folks back home felt Hitler storm. Back here in America, safe and warm. They thank God they've been on that boat. Hard times come no more. Grandfather had a business pumping gasoline. Groceries, green stamps, come back please. The Great Depression was a real hard sell. Put a padlock on the door. Grandfather manned a steel mill crane when G.I. Joe was called away. Nothing kills a man's ambition like a steady wage. The corner along the rail, a train approached and it slipped and fell. It sheared his leg off at the thigh. It spared his life, praise God. The union made sure that bills were paid till he was well. Then a job was made for the man who had a wooden leg. He put in 30 years. The company gave him a Timex watch when he retired, but the union got him a little bronze medal. It made him so proud, it's fixed to the stone on his grave. They called them to this land. Left stranded between shame and pride, we're never truly satisfied. How will we know when we've arrived? There seems to be no end. My grandmother still can't explain how she's lived so long, but nothing's changed. She asks the Lord to call her home. What does he want of me? She's seen her very own children pass, grandchildren too, now beneath the grass. God must have a reason, but it's not for me to know. Seventy years since the day they met, the rags not turned to riches yet. One by one they laid to rest. The dream is sent to me. Knock down, rise, knock down again. It's a way of life for working men. Till it does begin, the dream is sent to me. Instead of scrap metal, can we do Duquesne?
Sure.
Right, this is my grandmother, as I mentioned, never learned to read English, but she had the mind of an engineer. And she claims to have been the first female crane operator in the history of U.S. Steel during World War II, when, you know, all the guys had to go off to war. She worked in the mill and was given a position of responsibility. And of course, as soon as her youngest kid was her son, and as soon as he was grown, she was out of there. I know, you know, in the old country, you're not supposed to get divorced, but, you know, she felt like she'd been done a raw deal. So she actually, there was a place in Pittsburgh called American Discount Clothing. And she, what they did is they would buy all defective merchandise, suits. I mean, Pittsburgh Steelers would come in there and buy suits. And they would go, they would send the suits down into the basement where my grandmother ran the operation, and they would alter the suits, tailor them to fit everybody. And, of course, the guy who actually owned the business turned into a multimillionaire, and my grandmother still made like $8 an hour or whatever they made. And the sad thing was is that when she would have a day off, like my first job, she got me my first job working down there with her, and when she would have a day off, she would go to work because she didn't have any place else to go. And then when she retired, she would get up, take the bus into town, and then sit in a church all day until it was time to go home from work, and then get on the bus and go home. And so this is a song called Duquesne, which is about the town that my grandmother and grandfather and mother lived in, said to be, you know, you've probably heard me say this about 1,000 times. I hate to bore you with this, but it was the first city in the history of the world to have its McDonald's restaurant closed due to lack of business. That's how broke the city of Duquesne was when the steel industry closed down. So this is Duquesne. Door before the dawn, she walks 6 blocks for breakfast. She don't like to eat alone. God bless the waitress, leave a 50-cent tip. The small talk ends with a low. She grabs her purse, the scarf, and a coat. Joins the crowd at the bus for the morning commute. It's a 40-minute ride to the place downtown. That's where she used to work for 20 years. It's a Wendy's now. It used to sell men's suits, a tailor shop downstairs. Best friend she ever had worked with her down there. Morella, Maria, Hungarian Mary, speaking Portuguese, Greek, Slovak, and Italian. I wonder where they are now. They weren't young like me, and I'm 78. They might not even be alive anymore. Off one block and over two, there's the church where I like to sit. I never learned to read English, but I open the Bible. It's like holding the hand of a friend. I could stay at home, sure, but I'd go out of my mind. In all these long years, I never wasted my time. The candles, the shadows, the echoes of prayers. There's a service at noon, and then where? Say hello to Father Frank and catch the bus home. Turn on the radio and wait by the phone. There's pictures of grandchildren taped to the wall. Is it Tuesday or Wednesday? Well, maybe my Patsy will call. to retire. In your game, you work till your time has expired. We came halfway around the world to be here. For this? For what? Somebody's bright idea. Nobody really believed it would be paved with gold. Guess there's no place on earth that it's good to be old like me. Just wait. You'll see. Just wait. You'll see. Up one block and over two, there's what's left of the 5 and 10 store. In its heyday, it used to have a little lunch counter that only served breakfast, of course. It's a pharmacy now, and a nice, nice man makes sure that you take the right pills. And that's important, you know, 'cause sometimes these old people like me forget. These Americans, let me tell you, and I'm one of them, you understand. They live in homes they didn't build, eating food they didn't grow, traveling roads they didn't clear, work for bosses they don't know. Somebody picks up your garbage, get your water through pipes, get your power through cables, like a God-given right. All these Americans, let me tell you, and I'm one of them, you understand. They wanna kill you if you try to tell them that this isn't really God's plan. In Duquesne, you can't afford to retire. In Duquesne, you work till your time has expired. We came halfway around the world to be here. For this, for what? Somebody's bright idea. Nobody really believed it would be paved with gold. Guess there's no place on earth that it's good to be old like me. Just wait, you'll see. Just wait, you'll see. You'll see. Later this afternoon, I think maybe our next stop, because we're hitting every place in Pennsburg, Red Hill, and Green Lane today. We're playing. I don't know if it was the owners of Raw Replenish, the smoothie bar, or Green Lane Naturals, but the owners of one of them are from Saxonburg, Pennsylvania. Cliff, I know you're familiar with that. And they were talking about Butler, and I was just in Pittsburgh a couple of weekends ago, and they were having a Jeep festival. And the Jeep was first produced in Butler. And you know the history of the Jeep? You know what it stands for? GP, General Purpose Vehicle. It was an army thing. And then, they took GP and turned it into Jeep, J-E-E-P, and now, you know, teenagers drive them around in muddy fields. But they don't make steel in Butler anymore, I don't think. I don't think they make steel anywhere in the city of Pittsburgh anymore. Clareton, the city of prayer, up the Monongahela River a little bit, I think they still make steel. And so this is a song about living in a steel town when they don't make steel anymore. It's called Scrap Metal.
On the hill.
hill above the river, a slum with a scenic view. And now that nobody is working, you might say that the landscape's improved. The water is clean enough for swimming. It's now safe to breathe the air. In every last rusting scrap of that steel mill is gone just as if never there. Better get yourself some scrap metal. Better get yourself a souvenir. Better get yourself some scrap metal to prove that you work here. Mother works down at the beauty salon for $25 a day. She comes home all dolled up herself, smelling like cheap hairspray. My father sits around in his underwear. He's on a second six-pack by noon. For lunch, he stands above the kitchen sink and eats cold baked beans with a spoon. Better get yourself some scrap metal. Better get yourself a souvenir. Better get yourself some scrap metal to prove that you work here. No legs and his dog take up half the sidewalk. They're ringing a bell. The bookies are reading the sports pages, cursing. The game today's gone to hell. And miniature gangsters are stalking the street corners just to announce they are there. Babushkas went by and make the sign of the cross, recite Russian Orthodox prayers. The newspaper says people are starving. I find it hard to believe. They say it's true. Come holiday season, they'll send a reporter for man in the street interviews. Someday we'll look quaint in the history books, a photo essay on the museum wall. A hushed crowd will listen as the curator narrates the steel trade, its rise and fall. Might see a picture of your own father, titled Anonymous, hard hat and sweat. Some Andrew Carnegie and Henry Clay Frick, to whom we're forever in debt. They'll rewrite our story and give it a fictional ending, a glorious chapter. The sun will set and we'll wave goodbye to live happily ever after. Better get yourself some scrap metal. Better get yourself a souvenir. Better get yourself some scrap metal to prove that you work here. To prove that you work here. To prove that you work here. To prove that you work here.
Now, I can't read your mind, but you're probably thinking to yourself a couple of things. One, why don't they let the lady sing? And so I think if you were thinking that, we thought of that too. And the other thing you're probably thinking is, you know, these guys aren't too bad. I wish there was something I could do to help them. And the way you could help us is, you know, if you're part of a church group or, you know, you're having a family reunion or something, what we want to do is play music and tell our stories. So if you're having a picnic or having a family reunion or having a church event or anything like that, please invite us to play, because our answer in advance, unless we're already committed to something else, our answer in advance is yes, we will play.
Unless I'm married.
And then she's going to have us play at her wedding, right?
Yes, probably. All right. So what was it you wanted me to sing?
I don't know. What do you like?
Well, we have Diamond in My Crown, which is an Emmylou Harris song, and I like that a lot.
I like it. I like Diamond in My Crown.
I didn't practice it.
Well, that's all right. When do you practice? I'm the one that doesn't practice. Behind me in the lonely night, there's a peacefulness I find. Though I'm weary and in pain, when I rise to start again, there'll be a diamond in my crown. I have wasted all that life has laid before me. I have watched as all the green fields turn to brown. But I shall not disavow all these ties that bind me now. There'll be a diamond in my crown. Shining down someday, I know, brighter than all the streets of gold. When the burdens that I carry, I will lay down. And the closer I will be to my sweetest victory, there'll be a diamond in my crown. Just as sure as this old world keeps spinning around, and the strongholds that I've known, I'll see them all be overthrown. There'll be a diamond in my crown. Shining down someday, I know, brighter than all the streets of gold. When the burdens that I carry, I will lay down. And the closer I will be to my sweetest victory, there'll be a diamond in my crown. Diamond in my crown. Okay. Let me play our guitar.
Let me play your guitar. Yeah. Those are songs worth keeping alive. We ought to keep playing them. And so we did. And then about, I guess, August of last year, we came across Val, who was humble enough and just devoted enough to be willing. You know, drummers, they like to bang on stuff, and I know that deep down in his heart, Val likes to bang on things. But he's willing to just play a nice, easy snare drum with some brushes, just to help us out, keep time, give us some little accents. So Chuck and Val made this possible. And then along comes the catalyst. You know, like if you ever took a chemistry class, there's this agent called the catalyst that makes the reaction start to happen. Somewhere around September or so, we ran into Bonnie. And then all of a sudden, we had a little band, and we're able to play. So, and if you guys weren't here, I would probably enjoy it just as much playing to the spiders in my living room. But, it, you know, stories are meant to be told to people. So, you know, if you ever come across the Seven Habits of Highly Effective People, the famous book, the motivational book, Stephen Covey or Covey, one of his seven habits of highly effective people is begin with the end in mind. And so I sometimes think about what would be the end, like when you leave here, what is it that we are trying to accomplish that you might leave with? And really all I can think of is, you know, honor your father and mother and think compassionately about your fellow man and think about your purpose here on earth. This is a song about having been dumb enough to lose everything you have four or five times in your life and never losing your guitar.
Let me play your guitar, I'll be the singer. You won't have to lift a finger. Let me play your guitar a little while tonight. It's the only thing that makes it right. It's the only thing that makes it right. It's the only thing that makes it right. It's not the first time we've had nothing, although we have forgotten how it felt. Though it comes as a rude awakening to have to live with a tighter belt. Not once in our lives have we gone hungry, although sometimes we've had to break the law. Oh my love, don't let it sour your heart. Don't put yourself against the wall. Let me play your guitar, I'll be the singer. You won't have to lift a finger. Let me play your guitar a little while tonight. It's the only thing that makes it right. It's the only thing that makes it right. It's the only thing that makes it right. You didn't come with me for looks or anything I claim to own. So many lovers have lived through less and gone their separate ways alone. Let me play your guitar, I'll be the singer. You won't have to lift a finger. Let me play your guitar a little while tonight. It's the only thing that makes it right. It's the only thing that makes it right. It's the only thing that makes it right. And if there's nothing on the radio, you've heard it too many times. You can't afford to go out on the town. You can't afford to waste your guitar, I'll be the singer. You won't have to lift a finger. Let me play your guitar a little while tonight. It's the only thing that makes it right. It's the only thing that makes it right. It's the only thing that makes it right. It's the only thing that makes it right.
Okay, we got two more, and you know, I was saying about live your life with purpose. This is a song about the most talented person I ever knew, who died at the age of 33. He could make music on anything. Give him a chair, he could make music out of a chair. Give him a camera, he could make music out of a camera. He could make music on anything. And when he made music, people dropped what they were doing and paid attention. But when he left the world, he didn't leave a scrap of music behind. So I tried to take a piece of a song that he wrote and turned it into this. This is called Born with a Gift. Vision, but you read it all wrong. And you were born with a gift, but you misused it. And you were born to fly with wings you could never unfold. And you spent half your life trying to pawn your heart of gold. You spent half your life trying to pawn your heart of gold. You were born with an instinct for recognizing the truth. You saw everything for what it was, but still you confused it. You were a queen among common folk and a saint among queens. You were blessed with a vision, but you never figured out what it means. You were blessed with a vision, but you never figured out what it means. You couldn't find a lover who could teach you how to really make love. So you tried to find somebody instead with the proper ideals. And everybody tried to confuse you, to seduce you. But you were too innocent, but were you just that ting-tong? You were too innocent, but were you just that ting-tong? Everything you ever learned, you killed with your prescriptions for drugs. And you were coddled by friends, pretended they didn't know better. And the song you were trying to sing lost something in the translation. Everybody seemed to enjoy watching your frustration. Everybody seemed to enjoy your frustration. You were born with a gift you were afraid you had not deserved. And you were blessed with a vision and you thought it was a calling to serve. You spent half your life trying to pawn your heart of gold. You were blessed with a vision too beautiful to behold. You were blessed with a vision too beautiful to behold. Song that Bonnie sings called End of the World.
This is for old folks like me.
Why does the sun go on shining? Why does the sea rush to shore? Don't they know it's the end of the world? 'Cause you don't love me anymore. Why do the birds go on singing? And why do the stars glow above? Don't they know it's the end of the world? Ended when I lost your love. I wake up in the morning and I wonder why everything's the same as it was. I can't understand, no, I can't understand how life goes on the way it does. Why does my heart go on beating? Eyes of mine cry. Don't they know it's the end of the world? It ended when you said goodbye. I wake up in the morning and I wonder why everything's the same as it was. I can't understand. understand how life goes on the way it does. Why does my heart go on beating? And why do these eyes of mine cry? Don't they know it's the end of the world? It ended when you said goodbye. Don't they know it's the end of the world? It ended when you said
we're going to pack up really fast and get our stuff out of the way. There is some propaganda up here from some of our past shows. If you want a flyer, a little program from a show or business card and stuff like that. Thank you for listening to us. Chuck, Bonnie, Val, and I'm Robert, and we're called the Mercenes. Thank you.
Thank you for coming.